We know her best for her smart one-liners on Have You Been Paying Attention and The Cheap Seats.
Well, let's catch up, Mel, on all the fun over on Studio 10.
Hello, can you hear me? No response. Please, could you call for an ambulance?
That was a demonstration.
Well, I mean, with Studio 10, can you really tell?
Yeah, we should have cancelled her after that segment, but we just love her too much, and she joins us now from Melbourne anyway. Melanie, thanks for that, mate.
You are welcome. Our favourite thing to do is to take Studio 10 completely out of context. So it's a good time.
I was. Now, you are actually here with us on a top secret mission. Let's take a look.
We've been promoting Aotearoa as a holiday destination to Australians without them realising. What highly classified things has everyone been up to?
Ricky Lee, no one even knows you're a Kiwi.
I've dedicated my entire life to this project.
Thank you for your service. And Richie?
Yeah, I've been addressing the nation, reaching 100 million Aussies daily for the last 35 years.
Are you sure about that?
Give or take.
I've been dressing as the long white cloud.
Guys, this is all great, Mahi, but we need more.
Dickie overstating the ratings just a tad there. But you are all fine Kiwis. What's this all about?
So, essentially, there's been a big crew of us, New Zealand secret travel agents, where we essentially just spruik New Zealand and say how amazing New Zealand is without people knowing that we're saying that, essentially. It's a thing that you do by habit anyway, so there are a lot of secret travel agents that don't know they're travel agents. I just want to say we do love Australians. We do want Australians to come to New Zealand. A lot of people think that we don't like Australians, but it's sort of like, I don't know, like when you go on your TV show and you make fun of another TV show and then the next morning you appear on that TV show. That's the kind of essence that we have.
Yeah, and we just love it too much. We keep bringing you back. Mel, you attended your first Logies this year, which was awesome. We spoke to you just beforehand. Here's how the red carpet went.
Front and centre on the red carpet. Front and centre.
I felt so awkward. I was trying to do the Sophie Monk slipstream,
yes,
where you kind of avoid media by just, you know, following behind her. But then I was just in the background of all of her shots going, hello.
Now, we absolutely love you on the Cheap Seats, and I was so happy that I got to meet you up there as well. How did you find the whole event? I mean, the whole glamour and the fuss that goes into it.
It was, I don't know, I'm not married, but I imagine it's sort of like getting married where you kind of, there's a lot of hype and then it's just sort of done, isn't it? And then you sort of, you just, you know, it was just like a lot of build up and, but it was a great night and it was a great to meet you. That was my highlight.
She said a little dig there again.
Yeah. Do you feel that was genuine? Tony Armstrong, speaking of genuine, won your award for most popular new talent. How did you go with your poker face?
You can't put it like that, won your award.
Yeah, I can. Now, did you rehearse that face, just in case?
Yes. Oh, absolutely, yes. Practiced in the mirror of my hotel room in the morning. No, it was actually, do you know what? It's one of those things where you do hype it up and you do hope, you do have your fingers crossed, but then when you see someone else, like, really happy and have a great time, and it was like a really big moment for him. It was actually quite nice. It was sweet. I enjoyed it.
Oh, that's lovely. And Mel, a bit of a random one, but what exactly is going on here?
This was me at the netball, at the Vixens, when essentially the Vixens were up by about 10 points and then they were down by 10 points. So that is my face at that exact moment. And I just want to make it clear that the way that that's cropped makes it look like I'm double parked. That is, I have one drink in my hand. That is the person next to me.
And come here, have you been paying attention as back at? We absolutely love that show too. How much TV do you actually have to watch to do your job though?
Yeah, I mean, I have to watch a lot for the cheap seats so I can kind of, you know, keep up to date with everything. When I lived in New Zealand, I would fly over to have you been paying attention, and I had no idea who any of the politicians were, who any of the bachelorettes were, and it was actually so hard. I got like 10 points every episode. That was my high score.
It's very relatable, Mel, in my job here. But you brought up New Zealand there, yeah, so back to it. If you were playing tour guide to a friend who had never been there before, where would you take them?
So there's so many places. How could I possibly list just one? I would take them to the Coromandel, and I know there's like people go to Queenstown, they go to all those, you know, those big spectacular sites in the South Island, but I'm a North Island girl, and so I have to represent the North Island. And the best thing about New Zealand is that you can drive everywhere. It's a tiny little island. You don't have to just wait in airports and, you know, have the worst time. You can literally drive the entire country. So the drive from Auckland down to the Coromandel and then just lying on the beach is one I'd recommend for sure. Oh,
I've got to put in a vote for the world's steepest street in Dunedin.
Oh, okay, nice. Did you go down on a wheelie bin? I think that was
That's a good idea. No, it took the weird angled shot, so it looks like all the houses are sideways.
That's fun.
It's a kind of fun you can only
have on Instagram.
Yeah, that's the one.
Exactly.
Mel, you're absolutely fantastic. You can see Melanie on the cheap seats on Tuesday nights on 10 and 10 Play. And don't forget to visit New Zealand, everyone. You won't be disappointed. Thanks so much, Mel, for joining us today. You're awesome.
No worries.